cookie press, so if you don't have it, I don't think you can make it. I'm so sorry. Anyway, let's get happy again, because we're making cookies. Who doesn't like cookies?
I don't know.
Yeah. Okay, let's get right into the video. Okay, guys, what you're going to need is 3 sticks of butter.
Or 1.5 cups in other language of cups speaking, I guess.
Next, all y'all people are going to need 1 cup of sugar. Then, all of you guys are going to need 1 beautiful egg.
But it's so lonely.
And then, yes, you beautiful, you're going to need 1 teaspoon of vanilla. Do you want a flower?
No, I do want a flower.
Let me finish. I meant, do you want 3.5 cups of flour? And for all you risk takers, add sprinkles. Yeah, go risk takers.
We're gonna preheat our oven to 375 degrees.
I love preheating. Okay, you guys, now we are over at our mixer.
Gonna beat our butter into our KitchenAid. And so, creamy on medium speed. Medium, not high. Or low. Medium. So I'm just gonna put it into the stand mixer. Okay, and then we're just gonna put it on medium until creamy. Now we're just gonna scoop the sides off, or like scrape the sides. I'm gonna unlock it. Okay. And the, of course, this feeding thing. Okay, now what we're going to do is we are going to add sugar, egg, and vanilla, beat well, and then add flour.
So what you want to do is you want to have it off when you're adding these things, not having it going, because that will create a big mess into your kitchen. So let's add our things.
Sugar, 1 cup of sugar. Our egg.
1 egg.
I'm going to add our 1 teaspoon of our vanilla. Extract. Next, you're going to add your flour
in increments. That's a fancy word I learned from last video.
Yes.
Check that out, by the way, if you haven't.
You're just going to want to add your flour 1 cup at a time. And a good tip is that you could put a towel over so that when you're beating flour, it doesn't fly everywhere. And then we're just going to continue to add our flour. And now we're just going to add our last cup of flour into the batter. Okay, so what we're going to do is you're going to have it like this. And we have our disc that we want. We have the polka dot one that looks like this. And so we're actually going to be trying some different ones, because we want to. So So yeah, you're just gonna have it like this, and you're gonna start scooping, and you're gonna put it into this, and you just wanna have it very compact, tight, and just fill it up, and then you're gonna put your thing back on it, like this, and to squeeze it down, you're just gonna wanna squish it down like this so it starts kind of coming out of these holes, and then that's, you know, when you're gonna be putting it onto your baking sheet. But first we just wanna put it onto our, into this, but right now we're gonna tap this off while we fill it up a little bit. So yeah, so we're just gonna continue to fill this up. Okay, so you can see that it is compact in there tight. That's how we want it. So we're just gonna take this much for this disc, and we're gonna start putting it on our baking sheet. Okay, so you're just gonna do this, and then you're gonna like the handle, okay. Squeeze the handle, and it will turn out like that. Pretty. Olivia doesn't like them. She doesn't like polka dots.
I hate polka dots, so this is like a horror movie for me.
Ew. So while we are gonna put this out of the way, we're gonna continue to fill our thing and make more. So next we are just going to put it into the oven.
Did I put the other one there too, in the lowest? Yeah.
You're just gonna bake for 10 to 12 minutes, but you don't want them to be brown. You want them not to be burnt or anything. Of course, you don't want them to be burnt. But, and then 2 minutes cooling. So yeah. Don't they look wonderful? So now they're done, and you can eat them. But wait 2 minutes, because that's the cooling time. Awesome cookies! They turned out so well. Here's the swirly one. Here's the ring. And here's the flower. They turned out so well. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope you guys make them. They were really fun to make. Sorry if you guys don't have a Pamper Chef baking thing, or even if it's not a Pamper Chef, even though it's like, you know, just a different one. I don't know if there's any like that or anything, but yeah. So we're gonna eat them definitely a little bit.
Alrighty guys, please like, comment, favorite, and subscribe to our channel. Well, her channel.
Yeah, and make sure you guys check out our last video. We made chocolate-covered pretzels, which was really fun, and it was with me and Liv, so I hope you guys check it out.
I have a feeling I'll be hanging around here a while.
Alright, so see you guys next week on Fun in the Kitchen. Bye! Just kidding.
I'm in love with a mixer thingy.
Hey guys, it's Sarah here with my friend Liv.
Hey guys, what's up?
And today we are going to be making classical spritz cookies. And honestly, this is for a Pampered Chef cookie press. So, if you don't have it, I don't think you can make it. I'm so sorry. Anyway, let's get happy again, because we're making cookies. Who doesn't like cookies?
I don't know.
Yeah. Okay, let's get right into the video.
Okay, guys, what you're going to need is 3 sticks of butter.
Or 1.5 cups in other language of cups speaking, I guess.
Next, all y'all's people are going to need